How did I meet Eric? It was in October. My father and I went to Africa on a vacation. And when we got there, we went to this place called Banasville, meet my auntie, big sister, and I saw Eric sitting on the couch watching TV. I saw this person kept staring at me, and I'm like, why is this person staring at me? So when he stared at me and I looked, and then he turned, but it was so awkward because he had his arm was around my.
I sat between her lap, her daughter on my tie, was sitting there lecturing, watching the show, and then she walked from the room, she came out.
I asked my cousin who he was, and she was like, oh, he's just a family friend. And from that day, I just had that thing in my stomach, in my gut, telling me there's something more about this guy, and I wanted to know who he was.
I look at her, I'm like, damn, this is weird, you know. She a beautiful chick. I start reading her, but then at the time,
he was too shy, but I could tell the attraction. So I was like, somebody gotta make a move. And since I'm from America, they say all the American people are not shamed, so I wasn't shamed.
I couldn't say much, so I said, well, this thing.
So I was trying to figure out the right time and the right moment.
I just gonna leave it as it is. But I stayed there though. I was timing, the 2 o'clock in the morning. I just sitting there watching the one movie. I can't leave the movie because I was real thinking everybody would go to bed, you know, and leave 2 hours in the living room. Well, everybody stay in the living room with us till 2 o'clock in the morning.
But we decided to go on the beach that day, and
we all had a couple of drinks. But then what happened here was, somebody to her, but that was my first day seeing this particular girl. So when I hit the beach with her, the girl held my hand and we started walking out like, there. I hope in my heart, well, the girl gonna mess me up. Cause she looking good too. The same way my first time seeing her, but I was like, no, my mind was set on wanting, so.
But he was flirting with my other cousin. So I thought, oh, this boy don't like me. So I was like, okay, I'm still gonna make sure he noticed me and he know that I like him.
I didn't play no kind of foolish game right away. You know, I let him go. And then I went back to where Wannie was standing. We all started chilling, swimming, playing several games. And on our way back home in the truck, she and I were at the back. And then she just reached up to me and started kissing.
So that day we had drinks and alcohol. So I was like, I'm going to pretend that I'm drunk.
The next morning, I was in the like a barber shop trying to cut my hair. Then I got a call telling me, oh, this girl wants somebody to take her for a tour, like on LU campus, because she haven't been in the country since she left 2 or 3 years old. And something, I was like, oh, cool, that's what I wanted, man. Oh, baby. Oh, baby.
Who had the first crutch? I would say it was me, because if he did, I didn't know, because he was too shy. He's very shy, and I'm not.
I had him, but personally, I didn't say, I didn't make the move, though, because
we talked on the phone for hours and hours, and I finally told him like that I like him, and he was like, oh, I like you too, but I thought because you're from America, most of the girls that come from America never give attention. But I was like, well, I'm different. I'm not most of those girls, as you can see. And that was it. From that moment on, we started talking. He didn't have the credit, so I have to wait until midnight so he can call me with a free call. And I waited all day until midnight, and we talked for hours.
I decided to get married to Wannie because I feel keeping her forever is wasting such a beautiful, pretty, well-educated, outspoken. I love her height. That's everything about this lady I love already. I mean,
we decided to get married because we love each other very much, and we couldn't, like they say, if you love someone, you will decide to spend the rest of your life with them. And I love him very much, and he loved me very much.
She made my day. And you know, I know in relationship there's ups and downs, but for her, there's something about her that I can't keep her around me. We're all taking her to the altar and let it be done once and for all, because I would love to live all my life with her.
And he asked me to marry him, and I couldn't wait to marry him, and I accepted it. I said yes, and I would love to be your wife.
Getting married to Wannie is one of the best things in my life, because I find it to be, it's a blessing, and it's a great thing that God has done for me when I try to rest to spare everything that she got into because of me.
If getting married to Eric is the best thing that ever happened to me, I would say yes, because I never ever thought I would meet a Liberian man that understand me and that I understand, because most of them, I don't know.
I'm not having no sympathy of anything. It's just natural that I have met my soulmate and I believe I have found my missing rib. So it's time that I get married. So it's a blessing for me.
This particular one, Eric, he is totally different. And that's what I like about him the most. And I don't know, but he's just different. I love him a lot. And he have a different personality. He's a people person. He's outgoing. He's very funny. He's a funny person. He make me laugh all the time. And I really, really love that about him too. And I don't know, he's just my cup of tea. I like that.
What I love about Wannie is that, well, she always kind of tell me, baby, don't get stressed up. She's telling a woman that whenever I got a situation going on, she always come close to me and try to keep me calm, tell me good things, that, oh, it can be done, we can settle this, there's nothing you can worry about, there's nothing hard about this, I mean, we can all work together. She always encourages me, she always, you know, sat me down. I'm the kind of guy who, you know, loves to drink and do other things, and she kind of kept telling me, yeah, these things are good, but you have to have a limit on it, you have to cut this down. So I went through all of this and look at it, I said, but this is a constructive lady that I found. So, I mean, I love so many things about her that I can't even explain, that's a lot.
The banker in the family, I would say me.
The banker in my family right now is my wife, to be here, wife Wannie.
Because my husband, he's a bluff boy. He loves to bluff, he loves to dress up, and he tends to spend a lot of money on clothes.
I'm such a person who I love, I can say things in the sense. Things in the sense I just love to look good or something. So I kind of man who spend like $400 to $500 a pair of shoes.
And I'm the one who hits shopping. I'd rather keep my money.
I'll share $150.
Give it for something better. I mean, he just loved to buy shoes. So I would say I'm the banker.
I mean, she'll be there like, no, dude, you can't do this. You have to save for tomorrow, because this country, we're all fine with saving. If anything goes wrong, nobody can look at you and help you or even give you $100 plus to do anything about your life. So you have to save. And she has been the one who really saves a lot. Baby, when you come
to me. Eric and I have been together for 3 years now. And do we argue? Yes.
Do we argue? Yes. Of course, we do argue, but
something simple. It's not like anything major or something like that, but we make sure and make up before we go to bed. We don't go to bed angry at each other. I always tell him to let me know if I piss him off, if I do anything to make him mad, because I would do things like that just to get the attention, because I love attention.
I love my wife so much that I don't let her to wear clothes that would attract other men or other dudes out there. So I kind of, hey, no, hell no. You can't wear that one. You got to change it. Sometimes she get mad, I would change, she change about 4 or 5 times.
And if he's not giving me none, I would make sure and pick something to get his attention. And then when we fuss about it, we make up after. And I guess I like the makeup, so that's why I always pick a fuss.
We'll go out and then we'll have fun, then we'll come home, stay in our room and fix it up, you know, before the next day. So that's what I like about her. We argue mostly on her dress code.
Eric's mother, I had the opportunity to meet her when I was in Liberia. She's a sweet lady and she really, really loved me. So I'm guessing she loved me to be her daughter-in-law.
My parents are very happy, even though my father is deceased. But my mom, well, the first time she ever laid out on Wannie, she just took to her like her own daughter.
My parents love Eric very much, especially my father. My mother do too, but my father, because he and Eric tend to have the same behavior and same personality, so they really love each other, and I love his mother.
Every time she call me, she always tell me, you gotta keep that girl. She looked like a good person.
And they are very happy that we're getting married.
She just thought we've been married ever since, so it's over to you for my mom.
Who's the most influential person in my life as a role model? I would say I don't have anyone special.
My influential person in my life or role model is my uncle.
My mother is, my sister is, but someone that I look up to the most for like parental and guardian stuff like that, my mother.
My uncle, who is not here presently, he still lives in Liberia, but he was such a man that he's, when it comes to being respectful, he always has a family unique.
Someone I'd be like, oh, when I grow up, I want to be like this person because the role model. I don't have nobody. Maybe, I don't know. I don't have nobody.
He always advises me how to live my life straight, how to have a family is good, to have a unique family, stay away from bad cry. So in such, I look at his life and then started that full step. At the day that I'm here, whenever I talk to you, he say, yeah.
Oh, baby. On the scale of 1 to 10, Eric affection towards me, I would say 10. Because he loved me. That's what, for one, that's why he getting married to me. It's 10 because
my affection to Wannie is, he explained and said, one, or hi.
I would say it's 10 because every time we're going out, he always want to be, he always want me to be in front. And he always tell me when my dresses and stuff like that, I don't want you to wear that dress because I don't want nobody staring at you but me. So you have to wait when we going out together before you can go out. So my man loved me. 1 to 10 is too short. I would say 20, but yeah, 10 would do for now.
I decided to sleep the whole night with him shaking the air. So my affection towards her, she's so attractive to me that I don't want to get her off my eyesight in a minute.
And we getting married today, which is my birthday, and I cannot wait.
Oh, baby. Oh, baby.
Yeah.
Chapter 2.